M. Buisa. He's an holder in PhD in entrepreneurship. He's a full professor of entrepreneurship at JQUAT. He's the chairman of African Agribusiness Incubation Network, Kuku Bora Limited. He's the former chairman of Kenya Investment Authority. He's the former chairman of Kenya Paralytic Organization. He's the former chairman of African Technology Policy Studies Networks, ATPS. He's the director of Mukmik Consultants Limited. He's the director of Sorghum Value Chain Development Corporation. He's a board member of various organizations. Right now, he consults for the African Network for Agriculture, Agroforestry, and Natural Resource and Education. He also consults for the United Nations Center of Regional Development. This is a big man, and I know all of us want to hear from him. Professor Henry M. Buisa. Karibu sana, Professor.
Thank you very much for that very wonderful introduction. Although it's such a big introduction, I feel shy that after that very stimulating talk, imported all the way from Australia, I don't know whether I can fit in those shoes. I want to say that this is my first time in this church. I want to be a friend of this church. And I want to thank my colleague, Dr. Margaret Oloko, who thought that we should work together. That is so, perhaps, because we are in the same university. She teaches business, and I teach entrepreneurship, and we sometimes quarrel. What is business? What is entrepreneurship? We are actually twins, but we are not identical twins. I want, first of all, to repeat, perhaps, but in different language, what we have already heard, what's entrepreneurship, and I want to ask you whether you are actually an entrepreneur. To do that, I'll give you a little exercise to do for me. Then, I want to try to prove that nobody gets to be a millionaire working for another. You don't become a millionaire being employed. Millionaires are employers. So what I went to employment. And then the title of my talk was The Emerging Issues. So I'll touch on many, but I'll touch on one or two emerging issues in entrepreneurship. And then partnership. Because that is the thing that I was giving. Emerging issues in entrepreneurship. Partnership, support system, mentorship, system, entrepreneurship declaration. That we declare it and we can believe it. There is no one single accepted definition of entrepreneurship. But the core of entrepreneurship is innovation. Doing ordinary things in an extraordinary way. Or doing extraordinary things in an ordinary way. Doing something that others are not doing. The biggest or the most common measure of entrepreneurship is starting your own profitable venture. And when I talk of venture, it's not just business. It can be politics. It can be religious. It can be social entrepreneurship. I see a guru of social entrepreneurship here. So that's what I'm saying, that the bottom line of entrepreneurship is starting something. But that something must not be repeating what is already existing. That something must be something innovative, something that adds value to what already exists. Entrepreneurship is a culture. And what's a culture next? Sorry, I think somebody has already told us that entrepreneurship is living a few years of your life. We just heard it here from the author. Yes. Can you live a few years so that you prepare for better use and say you do not need to be an entrepreneur before you start. Don't wait that I will be an entrepreneur, then you start being an entrepreneur. You start now. You start being an entrepreneur before you are an entrepreneur. So all of us can be entrepreneurs. If there is a house of entrepreneurship, and if there is only one single pillar next of entrepreneurship, then that pillar next is innovation. Innovation is the single pillar that holds entrepreneurship. If you are not going to innovate, if you are not going to add value, if you are going to preach in the same way as they were preaching yesterday, then people will not come in your church. You can see how entrepreneurial this church is. They are talking here, they are being seen, and everyone is saying we are not struggling to. That is already entrepreneurship in the church. If there is another second pillar of entrepreneurship, then it is creativity. If you are not creative, forget. If you cannot do something different in your kitchen, if you are going to pick ugali, and I think from my accent you can say, guess where I come from. If you are just going to say the same pick of an ugali that you did, but if you flavor that pick of differently, many people will come. So you have to be creative. And the last pillar of entrepreneurship is risk. So the three: innovativeness, creativity, and risk taking. But in entrepreneurship, we call it calculated risk taking, because life is risky. Even as we breathe this air, we are risking. As we jump in the matter to come here, we are risking. So don't just take risk for any risk. No, it must be calculated risk. A risk that you take, you are putting in an effort now, and knowing that you can actually get something from it. So when you go to Safari Park and you put your money on the jackpot, and the jackpot, that is gambling. Gambling has never been a premiership. Now, many of us are poor, including myself. But why are there people poor? We were told this morning about opportunities. This is how I spell my poor. Poor is because we are every time passing over opportunities repeatedly. There are opportunities there. We don't see them as we are poor. Passing over opportunities repeatedly. We want to refuse to be poor. So that when they get Nyama Choma, then they can take it. So they now the Nyama Choma people will never have a problem with it because they're not committing the message. Will you say my guy there? Pardon? Sulfate? Yes. Yes. Kachumbari. In other words, we are now looking for partnerships. Isn't it? Look for something that you can partner with those guys. So that in fact you support each other rather than commit each other. So now I can to Kwanza Nairobi and excuse me, but it's the papers, they tell us. Business is going sour, they will send you 6 weeks under them. Yeah, when you are in bad business relationship, whatever, because you are committing it at the 1 minute. I'm saying when you start business, you don't want to commit to it. See whether you can reinforce them, see whether you have partnership, see whether the people in the business can become your customers and you will be up and around. Then let's go number 3 by 3. Yeah, is that not as well? Finally, so you can see the attack. So you clap. So this is what I'm saying. That what looks ordinary, like 15 squares, it is hiding some. I come back to this church. What looks ordinary here, they are hiding some businesses. And that is the pleasure we're going to make at the end. And already, I think we have been given hints. Shall I reinforce them? Let's go.
culture among us, we are never, you know, getting rich. And to get rich means reaping incomes consistently but honestly. If you are going to get income and honestly, then I'm told that's why people Mungai came with some regulation, because some churches are not honest. Some churches come to potential permanent, they put in water and they say that is the blood of Jesus. And then they say, bring three. Elefatu na miatatu wake happen to obey and ask the corner. That's not honest. I think I have my constitutional right, freedom of speech. If I am hurting you, please forgive me. But we have seen them only on TV. So, I repeat, nobody becomes a millionaire working for another. And I want to sample some of the richest millionaires in this world. Number one, tunamjua ndio, huyu anaitwa Bill Gates. He was rated as 79.2 billion 2015. And that guy left at year two in Harvard University. I'm not encouraging students here to leave university. But he's rich because he's working for himself. Number two, the richest man in Africa, this Nigerian guy, 2015 by the Forbes, he was worth 15.7 billion. He's not employed, he's unemployed. And in our own Kenya, the global, that gentleman called Bill Chikiba of the Mitiko was rated. These are people who are millionaires, billionaires, but they are not employed by. I want to look at, sorry, Walimu Mkiwa, please, I'm also a Walimu Mkiwa at the university, but we can look at the social era. Your social era fight. Mbaka nakuwa, out of stressed. Alafu, tunaendelea. Alafu, no check, no chop. The Walimu, because they are employed. Angalia, the budget ya Walimu. Let's go on. I'm seeing a lot of energy is spent on demanding for your salary instead of doing. Don't misunderstand. I'm not saying that you should not teach. But now that my colleagues, economists are here, that formula means the profit, you get profit when you subtract your total revenue from your total cost, isn't it? And at the total cost, that's where salary is. Because salary is a cost, isn't it? Your profit, your name, the employer, isn't it? So the employer, like that of profit, you reduce IT and reduce cost, isn't it? Now your cost is salary. So when they want to get rich, they go to TC. You cannot too much tear because prices are controlled. They want whatever. So you see, I am saying you will never become more familiar than an employer. So you better become an employer and you become a millionaire. Let's go on. So I have a message for those in employment. Please. Never depend solely on a salary for livelihood, even if you are still already employed. Do not let yourself retire in poverty. And that is the declaration we're going to make in this church today. Make entrepreneurship your retirement plan if you are sitting here and listening to us. So if while working for somebody, you do not see any opportunity knocking, then build the door because you have no door. Opportunity is knocking because you have no door. Build the door, it will knock. Build your door. We are told positive psychology in the morning. Develop that positive. Always describe the class as half full, not half empty. Neither should you say halfway. Because if you say halfway, you don't know. When you say half empty, you can see it emptying in you. You also want to say, so even if you have a problem, don't think that that is let's go on. So then, quickly, what are some of the emerging issues in entrepreneurship? Number one, issue number one, we have already been told, unemployment. Let's go on. Particularly youth unemployment. I think my colleague was too diplomatic. It's not even 50%. It's 80% of the youth. 50% of the graduates, but 80% of the youth in Kenya have unemployment. You are on our own. And the results are the youth, your prostitution, on our own, radicalization. So the emerging business government, we're saying the church must see this growing youth unemployment as an opportunity. Let us not despair. What can we do? What can we do? What's our role? Let's go on. Issue number two is women empowerment. Look at the three pictures actually were all made. But now the emerging issue is that we now have some of these, okay, go on. Some of these women, you saw them when Obama was here, Global Development Summit. I presented my students with lots of good innovations. Some of them got sponsorship and donorship. These are women that are coming up. These are emerging issues that youth unemployment is being considered a problem. But me and you here, let's look at it as an opportunity. We know that now women in the apprenticeship and women empowerment are coming up. There are a few. These are just examples. But we're saying we in this church can have a program. Let's go on. Go on. Issue number three, consumer trends. You are treated here. I checked this church as a website. But allow me to say, it is still under development. We should be selling our products on that website now. We should be selling Bible lessons on that website now. Even if I have my website, you can hear www.professorwizard.com. Go and read about it, but we need to. We only own it.
HM.
the strips of their suits for Georgia to see them, for Mubarak Reagan, hosting Mubarak. People now want customized good fitting. We can also have customized Bible lessons. Why not? Even our own Masika is Marika. Marika comes with a car and puts on his own name, isn't it? So the guys are now going, I mean, quite a number of one customized. We must identify, even from within our church, that there are people that might need special and go to them. Because if the mountain cannot go to Muhammad will go to Itamasio. Let's go on. So, what about partnerships? A partnership is still a relationship involving cooperation. Let's go on. I want to say that strictly speaking, there are several types of entrepreneurship. There is what we call personal entrepreneurship or economic entrepreneurship. When I do it for my own personal profit, then there is also political entrepreneurship, where we start bringing in efficiency measures for the government. Then we have what we call social entrepreneurship, and I don't want to talk about this so much because I have a group of social entrepreneurship just on my immediate left. And the church has always been a social entrepreneur, we know it. And then there is also academic entrepreneurship. So we're saying these four spheres, we can have partnerships. Why not? Let's go on. What are some of the gospel partnerships? Let's go on. The university, and we're here, my colleague Dr. Loco here, she's a big deal in our university. Say to her an idea, and she'll say, how can we partner with Israel? We have the government, I think they are very lucky. The government gives infrastructure, the facilitation, the university gives ideas, and they are all, go, I'm chasing time. They are all relationships that can be developed within those spheres. And we're doing it for the interest of the people, because we're all serving the same people. So partnerships are there. We really need just to explore them under the church as a whole. Let's go on. Ladies and gentlemen, if those small things can partner to build bridges, and we human beings are partnering to build walls, that is our world between 2 million people. We are partnering to build the world. And those non-human things can partner to build bridges. A bridge connects them, and a world divides. So what are you doing? What are we doing? There is water on the right and on the left. And these donkeys are tied. Each one wants to go to get that water in here. Picture number one. They are even almost jumping over. And then they sat down and thought, what's happening? Suppose